The best way you can support me is with a simple subscribe. Subscribe to my channel for more content like this.
All right, Mr. Telepedo TV. So this portion of my channel is long overdue. I've been saying I'm going to do this. I just really wanted the timing to be right. I wanted the projects to line up and be correct. I am finally going to do album review with Telepedo. I know you guys are excited again. I am going to review and compare a little bit some of the projects that I think they're comparable, right? I got two projects, came out a week apart from each other. And again, by the way, this is my opinion. Ain't nobody paying for my opinion. This is my opinion. It's what I feel. If you feel a certain way, go make a video. You get off my video. It's fine. I promise I'm not going to get upset. This is my opinion. I would love your comments on what I said in the comment section below. I'm going to compare two projects that came out in a recent comparable time frame. And you tell me what you think in the comment section below. All right, we got two projects from some very talented artists. It's collab projects, both of them. All right, so a couple weeks ago, Future and Young Thug announced that they're going to do a surprise album. I think they gave us like a day or two notice. And they came out with the Super Slimy Project. All right, y'all see my cool little graphics that I got going? Again, Future and Young Thug have did a lot of records together in the past, and it was only right that the two got in the studio and finally came up with a project. The relationship with All My Women, yeah, I believe is what kickstarted all this. I think they've had a couple issues in the past being Atlanta staples, but they finally got on one accord and delivered a project called Super Slimy. All right, in the other corner, literally in the other corner, I have Offset and 21 Savage. As you see, Quavo is in the picture as well. It was just tough finding a picture of just Offset and 21 Savage. Now, this one might be a little more out of the blue. Obviously, the connection is Metro Boomin. The whole tape is produced by Metro Boomin. We can't leave out. He's probably, to me, the top producer in the game right now, in hip-hop right now. I'm not going to lie to you. That boy is on fire right now. Metro Boomin produced this tape. I really didn't even know Offset and 21 Savage kicked it like that. I'm not going to lie to you. I ain't going to say this tape came out of nowhere, but this tape kind of came out of nowhere. Now, they dropped it on Halloween. So, to just put it in perspective, they dropped this tape. And let me grab their tape that they dropped. It is called Without Warning. They literally did it without warning. They just dropped that shit on Halloween. And from a sales standpoint, they're a little bit behind. I got the number on handy. I think they did about 65,000 in sales in 3 days. It's very good. Young Thug, or maybe it was like 60,000. I'm sorry if I got the number misquoted. They did about 60K, somewhere around that, in 3 days, which is really good in total equivalent sales. And the Super Slimy Project with Future and Thug, it did about 75 in total sales. I do know that number. And again, it came out on a Friday and it had the proper week to calculate the sales. So again, Future and Thug technically outsold Offset and 21 Savage. But if you want to put your brain together, you can put one and one together and think if Offset and 21 Savage and Metro Boomin dropped this tape on a Friday and gave it an entire week, they would have outsold Future and Thug. Now, as in regards to the tapes, right, I want to first and foremost commend all of these brothers. We get a bad rep for not being able to collab, and all four of these guys seem to have a great chemistry in the studio together, and they had no problems collabing on the tapes. Now, I want to get into Future and Thug's tape first. Again, Super Slimy. I really didn't like it. Just be honest with y'all. If you need some music just to kind of turn up to while you're pregame too, maybe get a spin in the club. I mean, it's cool. I'm not going to lie. I haven't been hearing a lot of that tape in people's cars. I'm not. And again, it's just what I've been hearing. Don't judge me for it. Maybe you play it more than I do. I really don't like the tape. I honestly, if you wanted to, just play the whole tape and you didn't know the title of the tracks on this project, I literally sometimes wouldn't even know we're switching records because all of the sounds pretty much are repetitive to me. There are a couple records that I do like. The No Cap is cool. We Want All the Smoke. We Want All the Smoke. I think that's cool. The Petite Water, I'm looking at the track list right now, guys. The Petite Ward is cool. I thought the stuff when they're by themselves, Future and Thug, when they do the records without each other, I thought that was actually better than when they collab. Again, to me, it's not better than What a Time to Be Alive with Future and Drake. Last time Future participated in the collab project. That's just my opinion. To each his own. I really didn't care for the tape. I'm going to be honest with you. I'll take it a step further. Future and Thug both had projects that I thoroughly enjoyed this year. It's just not the collab tapes. Honestly, I'm at the point in life, and I'm looking down at my phone as I speak to kind of talk to you guys and put things in perspective. I'm at that point in my life where I like their individual stuff when they slow things down, all right? For Future, I really like Hendrix. I'm looking at stuff up as we talk. I really like Hendrix. It was one of those projects where I thought Future became who he really wants to be. And for Young Thug, I really liked his easy, beautiful Thugger Girls. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I'm at the point in life where I think Future and Thug have more to offer than just to be the... I think these brothers really want to open up and talk about some stuff. And I think they're sometimes holding back and cheating the fans in a way. Because I think they're just too deep of artists to continue to give us the boom, bap, boom, bap, boom, bap. I'm kind of getting tired of it with them. Now, talk about this other tape, Without Warning. I thought Metro Boomin was absolutely fantastic on this entire tape. The production is splendid. You can look at little points where you see Metro Boomin put his highlights on it. I'm not going to lie to you guys. Metro Boomin outdid himself on this tape. I'm looking at the tracks as we speak. Ghostface Killers with Travis Scott, hard. The Ric Flair Drip, hard. The Masked Stalkers, hard. The whole tape is pretty dope to me, and I'm not gonna lie, my favorite track on the whole project is Rap Save Me. Rap Save Me. I'm from the gutter, yeah. I'm not gonna lie, man, that's my shit right now. I hope that one gets a rotation and some club play. That's my favorite record on the project right now. Again, nothing against Future and Young Thug. It wasn't my tape that I really loved from them, and I'm not gonna lie, Offset and 21 Savage, they got a couple bangers on this tape. And let me make this clear. The person whose sound stood out to me is the guy who's been in rap the least out of these guys. 21 Savage was the standout of this tape. And I loved Offset. His verses were okay. I'm not going to grade him anything higher than okay. I thought they were okay. I've heard better Offset. I thought Future and Thug, they were okay. Nothing that's going to just blow me away. But 21 Savage, his sound and his commitment to sticking to his sound, it's got to be easy to convert over to Thug or Future's or Migos sound when you're in the studio with him. But I mean, literally, Offset just stood, or excuse me, 21 Savage just stood straight up with his sound, stuck to it, and to me, he was the standout of the tape. I thought on that Rap Save Me joint, he went off. I like Travis Scott on the Ghostface Killers joint. I like everybody. I'm telling you, man, this is a hard tape. Without Warning would be my pick if I had to pick one of these tapes as better projects, man. Salute to all four of these guys again. Again, Super Slimy. It was all right to me. Really wasn't my tape of cup of tea. But if I'm in the gym, I'll listen to it. Nothing wrong with that. But this Without Warning tape is hard. And that's what I'm rolling with if I had to pick between the two. That Without Warning tape is hard to me. Again, tell me what's your favorite track off both of these projects. Comment section, please talk to me. Give me feedback on my video. I like the Without Warning. I'm not going to lie to you guys. To me, I'm rocking with it the strong way. You talk to me in the comment box below. Again, salute to all these brothers. No beef. We just comparing. It's all in the sport of hip-hop. Subscribe to my channel for more exclusive content like this. I'm out. What's going on? It's yours truly, Mr. Telefetto. And if you enjoyed this latest video, whether it's sports, hip-hop, or other culture-related activities, please subscribe to my channel right now. And if you want more from Telefetto, you can always subscribe to the React channel for more of your latest reactions and music and sports highlights.